You've just seen how to write a program that determines the largest of a number of input values, but that program had an annoying flaw. The user had to type in all of the values, and if there are a lot of them, that can get really tedious. What we really want to do is read the values from a file. To read a value from a file, you can use the scanner class, but you construct a scanner with an object of a file class, and in turn you need to construct that file object by giving the name of the input file. Now there's a bit of a catch here. When we put this code inside the main method, we need to deal with the possibility that there is no file called input.txt. If that file was indeed missing, then the file constructor would terminate with what's called a file not found exception. That exception is considered so serious that we must tell Java that we are aware of it. That's done by putting this clause throws file not found exception behind main. We're not covering exception handling in this course, so this is just another one of those things that I'm going to have to ask you to just do. Once we're done with this, everything else is easy. Now the scanner works every bit as the scanner you've been using quite a bit. You can simply call hasNextDouble and then read a value by calling nextDouble. Well, have a go at it. Modify the program that computes the largest value so that it reads the values from a file.